In this class we will know SolidWorks operating logic for creating parts, assemblies and details, which is fundamental to the use of the program. Let's start. The development of designs in SolidWorks is performed in three environment standards: part, which model the parts; assembly, where we hold constituent assembly; drawing, where do the detailing. These environment is controlled by templates that offset certain options such as units of measure. You can also create your own templates, but this is a subject matter in advanced courses. Usually started our work in the file part, where we create the parts, which can be assembled on the assembly file, forming a set of parts, or may be only detailed in the environment drawing. The environment part work with sketches, which are the sketches through which add or remove material to form solids. The sketches control model through geometric and dimensional relationships, facilitating possible changes in geometry. SolidWorks can change the play at any time, for the tools used are stored in the construction sequence, allowing flexibility in the design development. Any changes made in one part will be automatically propagated to all files that use it, such as assemblies or detailing. These changes can be made in any environment where the part is being used, part, assembly or drawing. Let's model this part to see how it works in practice. All this, then just follow because it does not yet learn to use the commands. Note that geometry and see that we have only one part, so we will use a file part to model. If there were several parts forming a group, we would have to model each one at a time, in files part separate, and then write in a assembly file. We opened a new file part and we will draw the sketch based on the frontal plane. We click on sketch and the corner rectangle tool, draw a rectangle starting from the origin. See, some lines were black and other blue. The geometries in black cannot be moved, but the geometries in blue yes. The sketch must always be defined, and its geometry is shown in black. This occurs by applying geometric and dimensional relationships correctly. With the extruded boss base tool, added material. Using fillet, added rounding. With hole wizard tool, added the holes. Finally, save the part. Now this part can be inserted into an assembly file. From the file menu, make assembly from part. Note the environment where we insert the part automatically. Here the main activity is the inclusion of constraints and relationships between components. The drawings can be created from the file part or assembly. Save this assembly file and then the file menu, make drawing from assembly, begin the detailed environment. See, we have a sheet where we insert the sites and all the details necessary to the manufacture of the part. These environments and those operations will be studied in detail below. We have seen in this class the main features of SolidWorks operating logic, briefly explaining how to work in the software.